Welcome to the replay version of Battle Number 7 in 1944 on Monster difficulty. Minsk here. Yeah, I did mention the soft cap was 20%, and that's the way it'll be for the rest of the campaign, I expect. Just with a few, maybe a few cases where it won't. For example, Warsaw will be a lot of infantry. A lot of iteration went on to figure out the optimal composition, but the basic plan was there from the beginning, because I've played it before. I know the key is to defend in the south and attack in the north. But the idea of coming in here and actually putting a plug in it up here is new. I didn't do that on Rommel, but it's just this force. It's too much on Manstein. I mean, I can handle them, but they pile up in front of you, and you have to start taking losses to get them out, because they have specs and this bastard sitting here. So I just went for just put a plug in it and shot them out of it. So a very simple plan, really. Attack like crazy in the north, engulf them from this side here, make sure the range free artillery and the specs can't really get into action, so they can be siphoned off on the, especially up here and down here. You saw that happen a lot. And then just when all the range free artillery and the specs out, it's pretty easy to do the rest, really. Anything else to say? Yeah, I think I did mention that these guys were upgraded to Möbelwagen simply because the 7.2s get trashed continually by the artillery. And also, you cannot put an 88 in here. It's not safe from the range 3 artillery. It's kind of interesting. I don't know if they have better defense in... Do they actually have better defense in anti-tank mode? Well... Also upgraded this guy because it's ultimately we cannot use the range 2 Nebelwerfers. They get continually hammered by artillery, especially if they sit right behind infantry, which is where you would normally want to have them. They just come forward with a katusha in front of the infantry and fire at it, and it's just on Manson. It's just way too much damage, and also it's too much damage. It was too much damage also on Rommel, so that's just a thing that would ultimately happen. And I think the wolf farming also end as Martius. Still keeping my 88, it says 88. I really like that they can switch over to anti-tank later in the battle. It helps a lot on Manstein. And also you can see that if you've watched it, you can see that I kept my two infantry in here with serious entrenchment, just to have a solid center. Then with Lieske sitting down here with a very fluid position, because I don't have enough units, so I need to continually switch around. And Cash coming in here with all my best tanks in this attack, while Leech has the three Jagdpanthers and the two not so experienced tanks that are sitting these two guys. Let's just let the replay run here, and I'll throw in some comments. Sutkus up on the north here. I know you can sneak in on him. Bodil comes forward. We can't hit that on the artillery piece because there's a spec. Hits now comes forward here. I'm always looking for kills on his, and he's the only one who can really jump forward to this because of his movement. I know they're coming in with a two level bombers in the north, and I know they will hit that Hetzer. So I just prepare a chain trap here with the fighter on the Hetzer, and then the next level bomber takes the scout, because the scout drives them completely crazy. The infantry we have in the south, that auxiliary, is not the usual junk. They are actually Wehrmacht 43s with the 3 stars on them. That's a bit of a peculiar move, that scout. He's actually not set to attack, he's set to hold position active, but he comes forward because that's an opportunity. And then he actually just stays there for the rest of the battle, because he's only set to hold position active. Here we pick up the two leopard bombers pretty easy, really. And I know I can postpone the force in the south. It's always good to spread out the destruction of the enemy air force, so you can so you have the resources for dealing with them, so you don't have to take them all at the same time. I also knew that they could come and hit that anti tank gun where I said Kittle with a trap. You see this now that they can get to the hits, and this is the ideal variant. That's where a light tank gets ambushed by him. Sometimes it doesn't happen. Sometimes the light tank takes the airfield, and then he gets hit by a T-34. And they got junk coming at us. That force in the north, I just really want to destroy it as fast as possible. And you can see Cash's force is just like a coiled up spring, ready to jump them. As always, we attack with overwhelming force when we attack. We don't. We don't go into a slugfest. And again, the Scout pulls the next level bomber. He's always the safest bet. And it's also great to use him because he doesn't need more than a fighter to protect him. Therefore, I don't have to worry about... it's easier to make a chain trap if you only need a fighter on the first one, because it's easier to get them to take the next target. Sutkus is coming in from the north, and I know they will not continue in his direction. They continue down towards Minsk because that's the nearest Victor Hex. You can see all the stuff that's a massive attack force that Kasha has coming for them. I know the level bombers won't pick the tanks, but I know a level bomber will go for the SU-122, so I just put Rodel on top of him. It wasn't something I planned, but I just realized, hey, why don't we just do that? Because the fighter can't reach it. The fighters can't reach any of the tanks, and he can't reach Rodel either. It's just a way to make sure that the level bomber comes in to hit the scout. And once they hit the scout, of course, they spot the wolf army, which is extremely juicy. So the scout drives them crazy, and he's juicy. But I think that because I killed these two guys, I didn't have spotting on the position in the center, so I needed to pull them. I needed to pull the fighter with a tank instead. I need to pull the fighter to a target so it doesn't spot my Jagdpanzer, who's sitting in ambush position. So I did like this, just to make sure the fighter comes in here and doesn't see my Jagdpanzer. As always, the scout, he's phenomenal at it. Doesn't matter if he takes a hit once in a while. This is a pretty safe trap, even though the Möbelwagen didn't hit that much. And this is also a pretty safe trap, unless you have a really lousy roll. Yeah, the Jagdpanzers are just helping initially, and then they move south. And this is just it's a well-proven tactics. Get them to run themselves out of ammo by hitting the auxiliaries, and then they're sitting there. They're easy to kill. There was the ambush, and I think the Jagdpanzer killed him. Ouch. Now an infantry took that in front of that city hex in front of Leechke. It means the scout sitting down here will never come forward. He does not have anything to do, unless I could give him a target, but if he doesn't have anything to do, he's only hold position active, and therefore he's not going to do anything like what the attackers do. So we can just keep him down there. I don't like having scouts come forward and see my stuff. Now just box in the two tanks and destroy them. It's just so easy. And also making sure that the artillery is either dead or out of ammo, because I don't want to have them sit here and take shots at my infantry. You cannot afford to take hits from that artillery, it's just... unless they're significantly weakened, or unless your infantry is entrenched. This was just the usual... well, don't get mad, good even. He rolls 100 once in a while. And you cannot do anything about it. I didn't actually surrender him. I think it would have been better to surrender him with SU-122. But it's a minor thing. See, I had plenty of artillery, so I could easily have surrendered him with SU-122. Just... it doesn't really matter. I want to get rid of him because I'm moving in the air defense. So we don't want him to see the Möbelwagen. And I want to see if I can build them into my position here. Get an infantry to sit in that forest between the two tanks, then it's just part of our defense line now, and I can stretch my tanks further forward. Okay, now that force has activated, and that's the force of the range for the tour. So that's nasty. They activate in turn 2, but they move forward in turn 3. And they have a big nasty IS too. Goodbye, Yak 3. T-34. Jagdpanda's moving south. And that force is now literally destroyed. Of course they get destroyed. They cannot stand against this. This is a serious attack. And we pull in an air attack now on the position up here using the airfield spotting as well as the infantry spotting on the tanks where they don't see the Möbelwagen. That was unfortunate. Really lousy roll. And that was also a lousy roll. I mean, there's Sturmoviks, but the action here was just... but it happens, and it's the main source of casualties. And you can see I could not have kept the fighter here to help. He would have gotten hit by a spec. Now the key is to get the specs out and to get the range free artillery out. We make sure they're stacked up here in front, so they can't really get them in. The worst would be if they get one in to, for example, this hex. That's not funny. Because I have a hard time getting rid of him. But they don't get to do that. I wanted to make sure I killed him, so I just brought enough artillery to do it. They have a funny way, these issue and ISU-152s. They actually come around the flanks here, down here or up here. It's kind of funny. But I think it's because they cannot get into position here. Even though when you look at this guy, why doesn't he move in here? He can actually do that. They have 5 movement. Not sure, it's probably because somebody else takes it. They have the big disadvantage that they move after infantry, so once they want to start moving, then all the good slots take. I'm also deliberately going for, I mean, it's both the specs and these I'm going for. I have a lot of these range free artillery. Yeah, I think the slots in the front get occupied, then they can't get in. He comes up here to fire at the auxiliary. That was the intention. When you have these auxiliaries, you can just make sure the specs can fire at them instead of firing you at your air units, then you can operate with your air units. You can see it clearly, by the time they move, there's no slot available here. So they just sit back and then they say, oh, we have to get forward. So they go either south or north into my position and get killed off. No more specs, well, at least not for a while. But that one was nasty. That's not funny when they come in like that. So, but at least it's not. The worst is if they manage to get in behind the tanks in artillery mode, then they become really, really problematic. So I had to attack him. I don't like it if they sit like that. I did not go in with a Jagdpanda against him because I didn't want to have my Jagdpanda sit in the front, where the infantry would start attacking him. There's another air attack incoming here. Another Yak 3. And now this position has started to get under serious pressure. And the key is just make sure that you keep it under control. Don't let them break through to the soft stuff. Okay, that was ballsy. I don't understand who programmed that. No ammo and go straight into the front line. Was that 1900? Probably. Can see I'm keeping it. This is an anchor position, and then it's more fluid down here, just to make sure that they don't get through. But it's a Liedtke's anchor position that where I stabilize the situation, or that's where what I keep. Also, that one has to go. So, what do we do to get him? We get a Jagdpanda in and keep stable around the glue them to the Möbelwagen. Now that attack force activates. You can also see the Spec sitting down there. He also is. I think they actually made a mistake when they edited the map. He's not in the zone where he activates, so he just sits there for the rest of the battle. He didn't get the order. He's sitting just south here. Yeah, there he is. There he is in the bottom of the picture. He's not in the zone where they activate, and I think it's a mistake. I think it's a bug. What do we call it? A mistake in the way they edited the file or the scenario. Yeah, I run the Jagdpanders all the way out of ammo. Just make sure that they can't break through here. And again, I simply don't have enough units to hold this front line, so it has to be done in a dynamic manner, which is why it's important to control this fortification, because then you can close it here unless they're sitting with a unit here or here, then they can break through. But this you can usually keep clean. Dead KV-2. Might have been better to resupply that Jagdpanda. Now it's okay to have hits now operate here or move in, but you do not want to have him hit by that big IS-2. The big IS-2 will actually attack him, but he can't get to him. Yeah, I think it would have been better to resupply that Jagdpanda, but still being kept under control. Yeah, that one tank actually goes across the river over the bridge engineer and comes up to try and sneak around. Just have to watch out for him. Now we also want to get this IS-2 out of the picture. You can see he stays here, so after he's spent his ammo, there's no way he can get resupplied even in clouded. It's just when you have auxiliaries, almost you should almost always think about getting them to pacify the IS-2s, because they just they're quite dangerous, but they become completely, of course, useless if they don't have any ammo. I'm continually keeping these auxiliaries in the airborne here, so they are. I know there's a spec coming in, but I don't know precisely when he's coming in or where he's coming in. So I'm just making sure that there's something for a spec to take on. Also, it makes them come to. I mean, if we're lucky, they move right in front of the tanks to take a shot at the auxiliary. Yugus 52. Yeah, I did waste the 20 tank guns here, but if you are to lose units, of course, that's what you lose. And you can see, because that IS-2 is sitting right next to the Victory X, ain't no way he's leaving. It's just, you can always use that against the AI, it is so stupid. I think it might have been better to kill that one before. No, I didn't kill that T-34, but otherwise that infantry could have been used to prevent him from retreating. But it didn't actually kill him. And we also got a nasty attack incoming now, which is coming in the clouded. It means, of course, they won't hit much, but it also means they don't actually want to attack. Or they're reluctant. So that means I have to knock them out, but my air defense is positioned such that they all four AA units get to work on the enemy air force. And therefore you can do this with just four fighters. It's actually it's not a very large amount of fighters. Should have fired the Möbelwagen first. So that's two of them down, and there's just a fighter and another of these big Sturmoviks. But I mean, you can see it matches up nicely with four fighters. There's the sneaker tank in the south. That one has to be killed. That T-34. And that was expensive. Thank you. That was not the intention. That kind of also wasn't the intention. I don't like ambushing them without defensive artillery. And now that the Jagdpanda has also been damaged, so they actually start attacking him. And I'm pretty sure the guards will do it regardless. Getting forward now to put a plug in the river crossing up there. Okay, that is now eliminated, and they're not coming with anything more trying to sneak south. Just need to pull the last enemy fighter in now. Then it's done with the enemy air force. And I think I had a bit of luck with the way he came in. He could have strafed a tiger for a king tiger for some damage, but I managed to get him in on one of the. I managed to trap him. I don't know why he chose that target. Maybe because the one sitting up in the north was the one I was most worried about, but he was damaged, so I think the AI evaluates it as a better idea to hit one of the ones with strength 15, because it's more expensive to the player. That's the last spec. It's just he was luckier that I was. It was positioned such that I could just go in and take him with a surrender. It doesn't always work like that. Dead spec. Again, you can see the IS-1 gets lured into hitting that Hetzer sitting next to Bark. Hetzer now afterwards. It's just, I really love doing that. It's a way to knock them out, spend the auxiliaries and units that will otherwise be expensive to kill, get them knocked out. It's difficult to take out an IS-2 without taking losses. Unless you do what I did here. Of course, if you get them, into an urban zone and trash them with infantry, then of course that's not very difficult. Yeah, it's not, just sits and chips away at him. One hell of a roll up at the outpound. The rest is pretty easy. And good, see again, they just keep coming into that pocket where they get destroyed. Because that's where the nearest Victory Hex is, in front of them. Now I guess the nearest Victory Hex is where the SE Grenadier is sitting. But I don't think they turn around. I really love getting these kills on the 88 towards the end of the battle. It's really nice to get both getting them to do something, but also having them earn the kills. You can also see I'm now just carving out a big pocket where I have them under control, so I can get all I can maneuver completely freely in the pocket that I created behind the tanks now. So all my artillery can move up to help take the objective. The tanks are just screening completely. Thank you. attack plus one on that mountier. You can see that tank is they cannot break through here, and they're not smart enough to try and go across the river with the tanks. They will actually try and get across the river with the infantry, but the tanks won't do it. It's kind of funny. I don't know how it was, how that works. You see now the infantry is coming across the river. It's a bit unusual, and I don't know why the tanks don't do it. We got spam. You can also see from the enemy pastiche that it's trying to spam. Well, it's not trying, it is actually spamming. Look at all that prestige. Just think about how many replacements could have been bought for that. Which is why we don't let the enemy take replacements. Okay, now just getting forward and carving out this side of the river. You can see the scout is still sitting there. And the spec. And those guards are just, I mean, they can take a beating. But tanks in the open, yeah. Okay, I think it's just about done. And it's completely stable position here, I can't do anything. Okay, just yeah, there was a bonus unit to be had here, but I don't care. And this, I did not want to take the fight with him because it's just, it's not really worth it. It's that guy is expensive to take out. You can't do it without losses, so I just went for put a block in it, keep them over here instead. And I didn't bother counterattacking down here. Okay, thanks for watching.